A mega bridge connecting Yeosu, a beautiful seaport in the southern province, and Gwangyang, the city of steel. The Yisunshin Bridge is connected with the world. The fourth longest suspension bridge in the world. The world's highest concrete pylon. High-strength wires whose length is equivalent to spanning the globe twice. The Yisunshin Bridge. Landmark achievement responsible for Korea's world ranking as the sixth top country for independent technology for suspension bridges. Now, let's look at the history of the Yisunshin Bridge, a structure that has reached the summit of bridge engineering and symbolizes the contemporary bridge technology of Korea. The Yeosu Industrial Complex, an industrial main artery on a rapid growth path, needed a new gateway to connect Cheollanam-do's Yeosu and Gwangyang. New road construction, directly connecting the Yeosu Industrial Complex and Gwangyang Harbor, the logistics hub port. The core concept of this mega bridge project highlights substantial savings on the trip between Yeosu and Gwangyang, which has been reduced from 60 kilometers to 10 kilometers in distance, and takes only 10 minutes now, compared to 80 minutes previously. The economic value of this bridge is astronomical when taking into consideration the production inducement effect, valued at $1.7 billion. Nonetheless, the roaring sea waves at the site of the historic Battle of Noryeong, where the fighting soul of Admiral Yisunshin still nestles, was another challenging technological battle. What kind of bridge can we build out here? Top thinkers and veterans of bridge construction casted a challenging vote. Dalim Industrial Corporation, a pioneer in the history of Korean bridge construction and the leader of special bridge construction. In the early 1980s, starting with the construction of the Dulsan Bridge, which is the first cable-stayed bridge in Korea, the Sohae Bridge, the first steel-concrete composite cable-stayed bridge, Samcheon-po Bridge, a cable-stayed bridge designed and engineered using Korean domestic technologies for the first time in Korea, Sorak Bridge, the first anchored mono-cable suspension bridge in Korea, Gobuksan Bridge, a concrete cable-stayed bridge, Handuri Bridge, a cable-stayed bridge that is the first bridge in Korea with a biaxial curved concrete pylon, Saepung Bridge, a curved cable-stayed bridge that is the first of its kind in Korea, Jukgeum Bridge, a single-span suspension bridge, Dandung Bridge, the longest single-pylon suspension bridge in the world, and Saechanyeon Bridge, the first multi-span suspension bridge in Korea. Dalim, throughout the history of bridge construction, has been a record setter in innovation and in the construction of the highest bridges. The Yisunshin Bridge is a miraculous achievement of engineering, completely attributed to the brilliant know-how of the above-mentioned Dalim. The pylon of the Yisunshin Grand Bridge is 270 meters high, which makes it the highest concrete pylon suspension bridge in the world. The bridge, with its harmonious design and use of the Korean traditional curve, symbolizes the dynamism of Gwangyang Harbor's openness to the world. Before the foundation of the pylons is built through construction methods such as SCP and DCM, the weak ground is strengthened by the building of artificial islands with block inner walls and internal reclamation work. After the reinforcement of the weak ground by using sand and cement piles, a riprap mound is built, and then inner walls are installed by using concrete blocks. The artificial islands are filled with sand, and these islands protect pylons against ship crashes. The effectiveness of this preventative measure has been confirmed by crash simulations. After the artificial islands are completed, 38 3-meter diameter concrete piles are constructed per pylon. Sacrifice steel pipe type is applied for maintaining hollow walls. A steel net inserted into the cast in place pile is assembled mechanically at the site by using spiral band steel. Underwater concrete is placed in the steel pipe with a steel net inside, followed by pile cutting work, and then the foundation for the pylon is constructed. The foundation of a pylon is 70 meters long, 30 meters wide. 8-meter high concrete and the 80,000 tons of weight on the pylon is transferred equally to the cast in place pile. The pylons are constructed using the slip form method, which has been applied with a cutting edge detailed configuration survey system for construction safety and to reduce the construction period. The slip form method uses a hydraulic oil pressure system, which raises the mold automatically instead of detaching it, and simultaneously places concrete. This method is very effective in shortening the construction period and in increasing the efficiency of the construction. In particular, the pylon of the Yisunshin Bridge has a slant due to the narrowing shape of the cross section. Therefore, the configuration survey is essential. For this reason, the configuration survey using laser and light wave measurement allowed for error-free, high-quality construction. After the pylon legs are built, two crossbeams connecting the pylon legs are installed. For the construction of the crossbeams, the heavy lifting method was applied, where crossbeams are produced in advance to shorten the construction period at the pylon foundation and lifted with hydraulic jacks. The heavy lifting method uses 20 80-ton hydraulic jacks and 15.2 millimeter wires to lift 1,300-ton crossbeams, and the installation process is as follows. First, when building the pylon legs by using the slip form method, install a temporary bracing in the middle of the crossbeam to prevent pylon deformation, and then continue to construct the pylon legs up to the top of the tower. Next, in order to install supporting members for the heavy lifting, remove or add slip form materials that may get in its way. When doing this, if there is sufficient working space, use derrick cranes to install the materials for lifting. At the same time, the upper cross beam is produced beforehand at the foundation of the pylon. After the upper cross beam is lifted and fixed using steel beams for temporary connection, the erection of the upper cross beam is completed by placing concrete for the connection between the pylon and the upper cross beam. However, since the total weight of the lower crossbeam is approximately 4,000 tons, only 1/3 of it is built beforehand at the foundation of the pylon. Then it is lifted and connected. Finally, the pylon is completed by placing the rest of the crossbeam. The anchorage that supports 40,000 tons of tension on the main cable is a crucial part of a suspension bridge, and different methods were applied in Myeongdo and Gwangyang. For the anchorage on Myeongdo, the earth anchoring method, which supports the cable using the self-weight of the bedrock after setting a cable on a stable bedrock, was applied. Earth anchoring is an economic and environmentally friendly method that minimizes the exposure of the structure. Where a 6-meter diameter, 33-meter deep vertical hole is excavated, then a 72-meter long triangular chamber. Strand holes are punched using the Symmetrix casing system in order to ensure the precision of drilling. Then upper and lower anchor plates are constructed for jacking. Finally, the anchorage is completed by jacking the strand along with building the vent and shed, which is the upper structure. The anchorage of the Kwangyang side applies a gravity method that supports the cable by using the self-weight of the concrete. The order of the construction is as follows. First, construct a site by a landfill. Then reinforce the ground using the SCP method. Next, to enable excavation without further reinforcement, construct a 1.4 meter thick slurry wall. The internal diameter of this wall is 68 meters, and the depth is 33 meters. When the slurry wall has been completed, excavate the sand and soil deposits inside and place the founding concrete. Then, use RCC to fill the space inside. Then place 16 meters of concrete to build the form of an anchorage. When this is done, complete the anchorage by constructing the vent and shed. The air spinning method was applied for the erection of the cables. Once the pylon construction has been completed, vents and saddles, which are temporary structures for cable installation, are installed on the top of the tower. On the anchorage, saddles are installed first, then the vents. A temporary hauling system is formed by connecting the entire bridge with pilot rope by using a tug to install a catwalk, which is a mid-air working area for cable installation. Utilizing the rope of the temporary hauling system, install 10 catwalk ropes along both cable lines. Next, slide the floor on the catwalk rope at the top of the pylon to complete the catwalk, which is an area for working in mid-air. On top of the completed catwalk, install the tramway support ropes, gallows frames, and cable formers. Then, modify the temporary hauling system, which only enables one-way transportation, to enable two-way travel. Place an air-spinning wire supply facility at the back of the Kwangyang side anchorage, then the preparation for cable installation is ready. Air spinning starts when the hauling system moves the spinning wheel, which is wound by four wires whose ends are fixed near the splay saddle. While the spinning wheel moves from the Kwangyang anchorage to the Myodo anchorage with the wires are supplied from the anchorage at the Kwangyang side. When the spinning wheel arrives at the Myodo anchorage, the slacking process, which loosens the wires near the anchorage, takes place. Then the wires are detached from the spinning wheels and wound on the strand shoe. And then the wires are retensioned. The wires are not supplied when the spinning wheel returns to the Kwangyang side, and the wire on the roller is lifted and placed on the saddles and cable formers. When one strand, consisting of 400 wires, is completed, it is tied in circular form in order for measurement and shape adjustment to occur. After the completion of air spinning between the main spans, the two strands in the side spans are additionally constructed in similar ways. Then the cable compaction process takes place, which transforms the strands into round cable form. Following that, the cable process for stiffening girder installation is completed through the installation of a cable band and hangers. The installation of the stiffening girder applied the vertical lifting method that does not occupy the major seaway in order for the function of the Kwangyang Harbor as an international harbor to be maintained. 90 blocks, which constitute the 24,000-ton stiffening girder, are transported from the plant to the site by sea. They are lifted using a manufactured lifting device and connected to the hangar ropes. The installation is conducted from the center toward the tower within the center span, and from the end to the tower within the side span. During the installation of the stiffening girder, the blocks are connected using temporary connection devices. Once the stiffening girder is installed, the temporary connection devices are removed, and the 90 blocks are integrated using welding or bolts, thus completing the installation. After the stiffening girder installation is complete, wrapping is conducted to ensure the durability of the main cable. Cable wrapping is the complete wrapping of the surface of the main cable using a specially manufactured wrapping machine and 3 mm thick, 4.5 mm wide S-shaped wire. Once the cable wrapping has been completed, dry air is supplied into the main cable using the air supply system to maintain the humidity below a specific level and prevent corrosion. In addition, the cable surface is coated to prevent rust due to sea breezes. And hand ropes are installed for maintenance. After installing the lighting on the main cable and dismantling the catwalk system, cable work is complete. For the 5 cm thick epoxy asphalt pavement, which was introduced for the first time in Korea, blasting is conducted to remove foreign matter on the steel plate deck before ASCON pavement. Then the zinc primer as a waterproof layer is uniformly applied to the pavement surface and cured for 2 to 3 days. After applying the bond coat between the epoxy asphalt and the steel bridge surface, 2.5 centimeter thick asphalt is applied twice to complete the pavement. The Yisunshin Bridge, which is the landmark and the very aesthetic beauty of the bridge appearance, will be tourism resources through installing the lighting and making the Gwangyang side anchorage a park. In honor of the achievements of Admiral Yisunshin, places to mix history and culture in harmony was made up through the stone pitching, which stands for his achievements to the anchorage. His best strategy, Hak Ik Jin, and the signal kite for siege, Jung Mo Ri, were embodied at the upper part of the anchorage, and the positions of the army he stationed before, Jua Su Yung and Wu Su Yung and Kabuksan, the warship he had created, were embodied along the circumference of it. The lighting to give greater prominence to a three-dimensional effect and symbolism of pylons and anchorages was installed, considering a remote prospect. In order to emphasize the structural details of the twin steel box, the lighting was also installed on the stiffening girder. Especially as installing the LED on the main cable and directing various patterns and colors of LED according to time and season, the prospect of the bridge in the night can be even more beautiful. The Yisunshin Bridge, mixed with the above-mentioned devices, decoration, local history and culture, will be a cultural tourist spot to represent a southwestern province. February 7, 2013. Finally, the Yisunshin Bridge, completed with Korean domestic technology, was open. This day, the many distinguished guests from all walks of life, as well as the local residents, came to attend the opening ceremony. Every moment, we had to take on new challenges incessantly. It took us almost 5 years. We strove to uphold the pride and honor of the name Dae Lim. We struggled with the wind and waves. We overcame challenging conditions. And we finally had success in opening the fourth longest seaway in the world.
우리 본사에서도 사실은 좀 좀 그 기술 개발이나 이런 거 독자 개발이 상당히 걱정이 많이 됐었는데 다행히 우리 그 소장을 비롯해서 그 현장 직원들이 자체 개발에 대한 적극적인 의지와 그다음에 자신감을 피력을 해줬기 때문에 오늘날 이렇게 우리가 자체 기술로 현수결을 설치 기술을 개발한 것 같습니다. 우리 직원 여러분들이 그 밤새 밤낮을 가리지 않고 고생을 많이 했는데 그 공기 여수 엑스포 때문에 또 공기가 상당히 필요해 단축이 필요했는데 밤낮을 가리지 않고 열심히 해줬습니다. 그 점에 대해서 대단히 고맙게 생각을 합니다.
As Dae Lim set significant milestones in the history of cable suspension bridges in Korea, now it is time for Dae Lim to lead the way in the world history of bridge technology. Thank you, Dae Lim.